welcome back. I hope you've all had an amazing week. Today we are going to be tackling this area, which is our carport. So in our home, we don't use our carport as a carport or a garage, like an open garage. We use it as a multi-purpose area where we store our outdoor equipment, like bikes and scooters. Tim uses it for his weight bench set. It's where I hang up my laundry to dry. We store a lot of our outdoor things, our gardening stuff, painting and tools, items, all of that good stuff. But it also acts as an absolute catch-all and a dumping ground for rubbish. So first things first, I'm going to be clearing everything out, giving a bit of a declutter and organization. And then I'm going to be adding in some shelves that didn't come with the shed inside the shed wall. So that's what I'm taking measurements for here. So this one is as well, just as a heads up guys, going to be a very long work in progress, so it's not all going to be completely finished by the end of today's video. It will be a multi-clutter, but it's going to be not a next week multi-clutter. It's going to be a long process that I just kind of, you know, work on when I have a moment available. If you're new to my channel, hi and welcome. Thanks so much for joining us here today. I hope you enjoy the video that you see today. If you do, please remember to subscribe. If you are returning but not subscribed, please do remember to hit that subscribe button. It only takes a second, it's completely free, but it supports my channel so much and I really appreciate it. If you are new to my channel though, my name is Naya. I am a stay-at-home mum in Australia. I live with my 6-year-old daughter, my husband, and our retired greyhound, Tom, who you'll see pop in and out of my videos quite often. So after taking measurements for the shelving system that will be getting put into the shed, I thought I would start off by transferring some of the rubbish that has somehow ended up in these bins, which were meant to be recycling-only bins, out and into the one that has the blue lid on the side, because that's the one that actually gets picked up by the council. What I did not realise though was that the lid on the top of it was actually tilted for a very long time and it's had rain fall into it. Other people have put things into it and all this disgusting liquid started coming out, and then I got a little bit freaked out by the fact that all this disgusting liquid is coming out and going, oh no, I've got to see it through. So I just, you know, get in there and start getting it done. Really gross. So, mummy has a shower. So I've just separated into two bags and thrown it into one of the bins. The other one's still there.
That nuclear waste, though.
That nuclear waste is from the bottom of this. So that's beer sludge, broken down, God knows what, biodegrading stuff. Rain, a couple of redbacks. I had a redback in my hand, I was like, off my hand, I'm trying to get some stuff done. So, that's one down, got the other one to go. And then these can just go to the skip or the bin, like the skip, like the dump. Still gonna get rid of all that cardboard at some point, or this cardboard at some point.
It's just the hard rubbish.
Yeah, I can book the hard rubbish day actually. So I think this corner is going to become hard rubbish corner, because there's a whole heap of hard rubbish that needs to go. Mostly this.
Yeah.
This is definitely going to be a multi-day project.
Alright, so moving on to this space over here with the shelving that you can see there. This is an old bookshelf that we had inside. No longer required it when we updated the kitchen and got some new shelving units inside to replace this one. So we thought it would work well as an interim to stay outside in the carport just for storage of tools and things like that. However, since then it's actually more painful than helpful. Like that some parts of it were helpful, but I won't be horrid, but it's one of those ones where you're like, oh, this will work great. But because each shelving section is really, really deep and different heights, different widths, different shapes, It means that there is no uniform way to actually organize any sort of functional storage, and every time I needed something from one of these shelves, you'd have to pull everything out to get it out and then again to put it back away. So that kind of resulted in everything just being dumped on the floor rather than actually put away where it's supposed to be. And that kind of shows in this footage right now. You can see how it ended up the way that it's ended up. So here I'm just going to be pulling everything out using these collapsible crates to organize them into categories, just so I know what it is I'm dealing with. So garden, painting, tools, that kind of category, ready for when I do the shelving inside the shed. There's also going to be an extra piece of shelving that I'm going to attach onto the shed that you'll see a little bit later. Okay, so after I finished categorizing the items out of the shelves and had the shelves all empty, before moving on to the rest of the shed, I thought it would be a good idea to go through and collapse all these boxes and to tidy up a little bit. As you can see, I've got the categorized items from the shelf in the background there that I've put out of the way, and then Tim came out to also give me a hand with collapsing these boxes to try and fit as many as we could into the recycle bin, and then the rest we've left just folded up to the side, at least out of the way and a bit tidier, until the bin is emptied so we can start putting those in as well. So that's an ongoing process as well, that every time the bin gets emptied we shove a few more of those in. So this is a few days later. This is one of the outdoor shelving units, or greenhouse shelving units, from IKEA. Super cheap, $20 Australian for the shelving system, as well as an outdoor cover for them, which is super handy to have, especially in the placement that I'm planning to put it. Neve loves helping out, as I've mentioned before, so she decided to come out and help me put the shelving together. And then Tim and Tom, the Greyhound, decided to come and inspect as well, which is always very sweet and helpful. But we'll be putting those together and then moving on to organizing the shed out a bit more. Constructing this shelving system was actually surprisingly fiddly. I do encourage Neve to help with everything that she can, that is within her abilities to help with. Having said that, it does mean it takes a lot longer to actually get the task finished. And in this case, it definitely took about 3 or 4 times as long to get it put together. But she had so much fun helping with using the screwdriver and getting all the screws put into place and tightening them up for me. She was in charge of putting the screws in, and then I would come through and tighten them super tight once they were in. So this is the second time in this video that you've seen me clear out this corner. This corner just always ends up being a dumping ground when it's got free space in it. But this time it was an intentional dumping ground. It was the hard rubbish that I had sorted out from the day before when clearing everything out and organizing and categorizing what is being kept, what is being hard rubbished, what is being donated, and what is going into the normal everyday council bins. But at this stage, I had to get all those hard rubbish moments out so I could then place the shelving system from IKEA in. So the reason I've chosen to do this is because I just need a little bit of extra storage space outside of the shed, as well as the shelving that I'll be putting in the shed later. But I was looking for a kind of a cheap solution that would also still be practical. So this is now my gardening section. So the cover is weather resistant, so it keeps everything dry, but I just keep all of my basic everyday or weekly gardening stuff in there. And it just makes it so much easier. It's much better organized now. It means I know exactly where I need to go for which product that I'm after. All the big equipment is inside the shed when I need to get that. But it's added so much more storage, guys, for a very cheap solution. And all I'm doing here is measuring where its anchor holes are, drilling through the shed using a metal drill bit, and then adding some screws through. But when I add the screws through, I didn't have anything with like a nut or a bolt available, so instead you'll see me shortly just grab a piece of scrap timber just to stick on the other side to work as a bite block, basically, so to give the screw something to bite into to hold it in place and anchored to the shed, so there is no risk of it falling over on anyone or getting blown over in windy day, like getting blown over on windy days. Alright, so this is just a bit of a walkthrough for you, a bit of work that I did off camera. So all I've done to add the shelving into the shed is get a couple timber pieces, treated timber pieces, line them up, add some screws through from the outside into the timber inside, so that way I have something to attach the brackets to, because this metal is too thin to actually support a bracket by itself. And then I've got some MDF board there that I'm going to cut up to the correct size for the shelving. And now it's going through with an outdoor roof and gutter waterproof sealant, just to watertight those screws to make sure that everything inside is still going to stay watertight and safe from the rain and the weather elements. I'm also adding the sealant to the outside of the screws as well, where we anchored in the IKEA product, the IKEA shelving. And now I'm going through, having already done the brackets on one side, using a little leveler and leveling out the brackets for the other side, ready for when the shelves go in. Now, the only thing I would notice about mention about the shelves with the MDF is I definitely accidentally went too thin on my MDF, and it is now, since having put it in, bowing in the middle because it was definitely too thin. So if you all want to try this, I would definitely go for the thicker, stronger MDF, or do a third bracket in the center just to help support the shelves. Just going for the slightly thicker MDF though would definitely be the more cost effective option overall. All right, and the final step, guys, you saw me cut out the shelving using my circle saw, and now I'm just taking those in and attaching them to the brackets underneath with some very, very small screws. And now it's just a matter of going through the items that I categorized previously and organizing them into the sheds, into the shelving, and refilling that shed back up to make sense. Whilst I do this as well, you'll see that I continue decluttering, like do a second round of decluttering as I go. And shout out if y'all have done this as well, but I find that I always seem to miss things that really are useless and I really don't need during the first declutter. So I'll declutter once and then I'll declutter again as I put it back, just to make sure I'm definitely getting rid of anything that's not needed and not holding on and losing space to things that are definitely not needed. Yeah, well, that's it from me today. Thank you so much for joining me. If you've made it through this far, I hope you've enjoyed it and found some motivation to do a bit of a clean out of one of those spaces that are always practical but not necessarily beautiful, like a garden shed. If you haven't subscribed, please remember to hit that subscribe button on your way out. I do post videos like this one, as well as mostly inside cleaning motivation videos weekly. Otherwise, I hope you'll have an amazing week and I'll see you next week for the next video. Also, just want to point out that yes, that is my outdoor dining table. I've brought it over to use as a trestle because I do not own one, and I will be putting it back very quickly after I finish clearing off all the sawdust with the windblower. And as I said, this project is definitely an ongoing project, but that's it for now. See you all next week, guys. Bye.